Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Time Shot server. Who is this person? Who is talking? Is this a person? Is this a cat? I'm not quite sure anymore either. Die. I was just breeding some cows at spawn. Because I need, well, I need two things. I need meat, and I need leather, and I didn't get leather from that. I need food is really why I'm here. So, where have I been for the past 3 months on Time Shot? I've been taking a hiatus, if you didn't know. I'm going to take all this meat, though. Let's leave one behind. I'm going to cook all this up back at my base. Because I need food. Good food. Wait, wait, what else is in here? Let's take a check. Some cooked rabbit. I don't really care for a rabbit. Some pork chops. Lots of eggs. Some chicken. I'll take a stack of pork chops. Sure, why not? I also took a stack of these beets. Beetroot. I think you can eat them. I don't really know. I guess we're going to find out. I don't know much about them. Other than that they grow. And that you can harvest them. The seeds. Community livestock farm. Okay, yeah. That's where it just was. But yeah, I'm at spawn because I needed food. And it's been a while since I've recorded on Time Shot. Very long while, but that hasn't meant I haven't been playing on here. I've actually been playing on here quite a bit over the past month, maybe? Yeah, probably about a month. I've been really trying to work hard on finishing up the Age of Codewing builds. Like, a lot of work. To try to get that finalized, because the, spoiler alert, the world is ending, so to speak. We're wrapping up Time Shot Season 1. We've kind of announced that we're thinking about resetting the map and everything. So we're trying to wrap up as much as possible, and I really wanted to, you know, it was my project that I started since the beginning of it over 2 years ago, and I really wanted to wrap it up before the world ends. The world is ending. No, before the map ending, I guess. Let's try to eat these beetroots. Let's see what they do. Well, I want to get more saturation down, so I'm going to wait a minute. Code is not a cat. Yep. This is true. This is true. I've been found out as I've been a human, but also my skin is still a tiger. Rawr. Yeah. Let's put that sign in here. I don't want that. So I've been working, guys. Like, a lot of work. Okay, let's keep getting the saturation now. Let's hop around a little bit. Like, I've been doing a lot of stuff on here, and I've been getting a little bit of help, too, but I've been doing a lot of work. A lot of work is put in. A lot of hours. I don't think you guys are really appreciating how many hours I've put in. Okay, we got three haunches down. Let's try to go for four, because I don't know if this will heal three or if it'll heal four. I just want to see what the saturation is. It's probably not very good because it's a beet. It's probably like a cookie. Let's hop over here for a second. Okay, now we got four down. All right, let's four and a half. Let's just go to five. Now that I'm doing all this. Okay, there we go. That's five. All right, now I'm going to eat. Half a haunch? One half haunch? I'm going to eat these all day. Can you cook the beets? Cook the beet. Do do do. I don't know. I wonder if you can. Okay, well, that was fun. I ate like 10 of those just to get full 10 haunches. So, interesting. Let's see if I can cook them. Let's try it out. Oop, that's not cooking. Oh, I got some meat in there. Oop, nope. They don't go in a furnace. Oh, wait, do they? Nope, there's no cooking happening. Okay, these are useless. Thanks, Mojang, for adding a crop that's useless to the game. All right, let's put some that other meat in there. We'll just eat this food that we have, and these are garbage. Let's just give them to these sheep. Enjoy, sheep. Sheep are purple now to match all the purple stained clay. They were blue before, but I decided to change them purple. Because everything is purple. So it made more sense. What am I doing in here? Nothing. I'm not doing anything. I took all this wheat too. I didn't want this. Here, you guys can have some. Ah, make a baby. There you go. Enjoy the wheat. Let's hop over here before I spoil things and show what I've done so far. I wanted to go to our... Well, I'm spoiling more things. I wanted to go over here and look at our board of completion that we had things of left to do. So there was like... I can't remember what else was up here. What did we finish last that I actually recorded out here? Maybe... Oh, I know. It's the cathedral. The cathedral was the last thing I did on this board, and I took it off. So, what I had left was the archery range, the blacksmith, the wonder, the university, the siege workshop, and the castle. I've completed in quotation marks, air quotes. I haven't fully completed any of them, really. But they are done as far as building-wise. The archery range, the blacksmith. Actually, I did the blacksmith first, then I did the archery range. Then I did the siege workshop, and the most time I've spent has been on the castle. I've spent a lot of time on this castle. You guys have no idea. The work. The works. I mean, I guess it's... everything's kind of been a time sink to an extent, but I put a lot of time into that castle, I feel like. So, let's check out them in order of which I build them. Here is the blacksmith. And if you follow me on Twitter, I tweeted this out like a month ago saying I was doing some work on TimeShot. And here it is. Here's the blacksmith that I've designed. Just like in the game, it's kind of got like a smokestack on the middle. I kind of wanted to get some cobwebs to make it kind of the smoky look off the top. But I didn't really have any cobwebs at hand. So it was like one of those details that I was maybe going to add that I didn't really get a chance to. And then in the middle, I used those new smoky blocks. I forget what they're called already. But I used them to kind of give the effect of like glowing embers at a blacksmith. So you cast and mold things, and then you dip it in the water, and then you smash it on the anvil, and then you do go back and forth. You're doing this thing back and forth. So that's kind of what's going on in the blacksmith. And then I added like a little water bucket, a little lava bucket, and a bunch of materials that have been crafted in here. And as I mentioned before, I've been getting a little bit of help on this stuff too, and Nasia's been helping me quite a bit to organize this stuff, and also like turning all of these things all different ways, which has not been as helpful. Because they're all like sideways and upside down, and yeah. But she's been helping me with some of the details, some of the build stuff, kind of getting things going. So yeah. And then here's the inside. Lots of vines. I think most of these vines were her spamming them everywhere as well, which I don't mind it. It kind of gives it a nice like aged look. Oh yeah, I was kind of playing with designs for the lights. There's three different lights in here. There's glowstone, then there's the redstone lamps. I think the redstone lamps look the best in here. I'm gonna need to replace that one and that one. And then here's like a little blacksmith kit, his little stuff. So yeah, that's the blacksmith. That's building number one. Building number two is the archery range. Let's go look at that. I did do a pathway to there, and then I did a pathway up to here for the archery range. So this is our archery range here. It's like a little box over here, and then I even made this like almost functional because you can actually shoot these. If I can aim, there we go. You can actually shoot these just like at a real archery range to light them up. It's kind of a neat thing I thought would be fun to add to here. So yeah, that's the archery range area. And then I did the interior. I tried to add a lot of details with the same style that I've been doing before with the stone brick, the purple or blue stained clay. And what else is my other element that I always add? Like wood of some sort, the oak or the spruce wood I've been using a lot. So I added that here too, and then I got a nice little area inside, and then little archery supplies and things in here, little rooms. And let's see if I can get a better angle, like if I walk outside of it. I forget where the best angle to view this one was. It's kind of hard to get good spots to view them, because otherwise it just looks like a building, you can't really tell. I wonder if up here would be good. Ow. That does okay. It looks okay, but it's meant to be like a little tower over here and then a building on the inside too. It's kind of how it looks in the game. Let's go back. Eat our apples for now. And then on the inside, we made like a little kind of like pubish thing. It's kind of what I had said I thought should be in here. Like a little area to sit down and take a load off on the clicky tables. But I thought it turned out quite nice. I think Inasia did this, the stained glass design. It looks good. And then from the top of the tower, I like these. I really like making these towers because, and then I just like peeking out through the little peepholes to see like what kind of view I actually have from these. Like, I don't know. There's something about it that's just really cool. That's a castle. It's a castle, guys. The castle. I love how it looks. I honestly do. I'm really proud of how it looks. It's amazing. Okay, that's coming up. We haven't gotten to that one yet because we're still on the archery range. Do not forget this. So this is the archery range. Hope you guys like it. I think it turned out nice. I think all of them really turn out quite nice. Even though they kind of look the same, they all have a general same theme to them. And I think it, I don't know. I just try to implement similar color patterns, but with different style and different elements added to them. Like I try to make the roofs different on pretty much all of them. I try to, you know, do different things with the clay where I can. A lot of times I end up doing stripes because it's easy. But, you know, I do the kind of the stripe pattern on these. But anyways, yeah, I think they all look pretty good. I really like how the blacksmith turned out too. I really do. It looks really cool. I like the roof. I like the little thing. Looks good from over here too. I'm proud of my builds. I got to do a pathway now to extend it to here. To the siege workshop. So this is something too that Inasia helped with. She's been helping, like I said, she's been helping a lot with these. I've been helping at her base too. So it's not just like she's helping me. I'm helping her too. So it's kind of a mutual thing we have. Like, don't just think that she's doing like all the work because she's not. I have to come up with every single idea. She's got nothing to share. She just is like a tag along for sure. That sounds like her, right? Yeah, I'm just joking. She's been very helpful. She's been coming up with a lot of the ideas because I've been getting stuck on things, and it's like it's helpful to have another perspective to kind of bring it forward. So anyways, this is a trebuchet, I think is how she pronounced it, but I pronounce it trebuchet. It's supposed to be a trebuchet that launches this log like over the top, you know, at castles and stuff. But this is supposed to be the siege workshop that we have here. So this is where these are built and like catapults. And what else would be built here? Other stuff like that. I can't remember those little ones that shoot the arrow. They're kind of like a crossbow type of bolt that they shoot. But it's a big one. I can't remember what those are called right off the top of my head. I didn't really finish this because this is just a big open building in here. I got to figure out what I'm going to do in here. To be quite honest, because I'm not quite sure what this should be. And then in here we added like materials for like builds, you know, for these actual builds. So I just put random blocks in and then spammed them on the ground, and then we ended up making a parkour puzzle out of it to add something different. Oop, I failed. Add something a little different to the inside of some of these buildings to make it more interesting. I'm failing at parkour. Oh, I did it. Good job. And it's a piece of dirt. I wanted to make it so that you couldn't actually access the chest. But I guess that was too trolly, so I wasn't allowed to do that. Anyways, that's the siege workshop. I want to kind of just like, I have these chests just sitting around from the recent builds. I clean them up afterwards usually, but these ones have been sitting for a little while. There's one by the cathedral, there's one over here, and then there's one by the archery range too. Hi, what are you doing here, huh? Huh? What have you been doing in my blacksmith? Where did you spawn? Okay, let's eat this apple. Let's go and get that food as well. See if that steak's done, because I'm going to need that. I'm going to need that steak. Wrong way. Over here. Let's maybe sleep in our bed, too, to make it day. Wait, what was that? Oh, anvil. Okay. I thought there was something... I don't know what I thought. I thought I saw something there. Who knows? take a quick nap. See how much steak we got. Okay, that one's done. And done. Wow, that was like perfect timing right there. Okay. Now we need to head up to the castle on the hill. So I was really hesitant about doing this because I knew how much of it work it was going to be. And I wasn't sure whether or not I should try to do a castle. And then I ended up doing it because magma blocks, that's what they're called. Because I was being told I had to. So I ended up doing it. Oh, these trees are going to have to come down too. I'll take those down later. They don't match the landscape here. It's oak only, please. But I'm going to have to build a path up to this castle that's probably going to go somewhere along this mountainside. I want to try to keep it. Look at that guy hiding under there. Yeah, I see you. Getting rid of that. You're not going to be able to hide under there anymore. Oop. Like created a new one. I have an arrow in my shoulder. Ouch. Grab that. Yeah, so I'm going to need to make a path. I kind of want to make it so that I can see the castle as I come up to it. I don't want to... Maybe I got to eliminate some of these trees again. I was trying to add some greenery back to it, but this is the castle from the exterior. This is what I've done, been doing. This is so much work doing this stuff, trying to design this, trying to come up with things, patterns and whatnot. But yeah, it's kind of got like a little 8 or an infinity symbol, but really it's just a design that I came up with on the fly. Wasn't really meant to look like anything, to be honest, but that's what it is now. But here's the little entrance. So this is kind of confusing because I was looking at the image for the castle and the entrance on it is actually, it starts on this side. And I didn't want to make an entrance over here because it's, yeah, it's ugly. But so I made the entrance on the other side and it's not functional either. Like there's no pathway that's coming up from this side. This is a mountain. So I flipped it and added it to the other side. This is actually not the entryway. The entryway is through the side and then you have to cross like a drawbridge to actually get into the castle, which I thought was kind of cool. And I hadn't noticed about the game before was that that was the way you had to enter. So I built that, we built that together and it looks like this and there's lots of detail and design and I put in some nether brick because it's kind of purplish, this nether brick-ish stuff, and it kind of made sense with the color scheme I was going for. But this is what it looks like and everything. I can get rid of these torches now because I added these lamps, I think. Yep, I hope this isn't too dark. But also, these lamps melted some of this ice that I had detailed on the side. So it's like a little moat underneath, too. There's water. Yeah. And then we have, like, each of these towers. So there's actually 6 towers. This is these two front ones are smaller. Then there's 2 circular ones on either side. And then the back ones are kind of a square shape. I'll see if I can show that, too. But I tried to add a lot of detail. The detail on these ridges is pretty much the same on all 6 of them, but the patterns in the ceiling are actually different for each of them. For some of these rooms, I'm not even sure what I'm going to do with them, to be honest. Like, they might just be an open room like this, and that's all it is, because I don't know if I'll have time for the details. And the same is true for pretty much all of these. They look really cool when you look at them and you look up into them and see how big they are. I don't know. There's just something cool about that. I've never taken on a build quite this big before. I have not tried to. I've been intimidated by it, so I've never really done it. Here's like the front pattern that you might have seen from down below. Tried to add some depth and some different design there. And then we have like a little archway, which that doesn't really matter, I guess, to look at. We'll get to that in a second. So this is one of the other towers. Yeah. I guess we're going to go to the top of the towers. We don't need to look at them right now. But I've attempted to build a giant tree here. I've attempted. And it's missing something. I thought maybe it was missing vines. I'm not 100% sure if it is. I'll try to add some right now and see if it maybe like enhances it a little bit. But I don't know if I've got too many grass blocks, if I got not enough bulkiness, like these tendrils look a little bit strange too. I'm not sure. I'm trying to figure out what needs to be different about it, if that makes sense. I'll try to add some of these and see how that maybe looks differently. But I tried to do a giant tree, essentially, and I've had the idea before, but Anasia seems to think that she copyrighted this idea and that it's hers only, even though I've seen it done a million times before too. But yeah, there's another tower. Towers. So to get to the top from here, I just added three ladders on the back. I just thought it was kind of cool. Oh, and the inside with the patterns too. Like, I don't know. I like this build a lot. I really do. I like the things that have been done with it. I think it's turning out really nice. Here's the different towers from the top. And there's the giant tree. It's got snow covered. It's cool. Piece snow covered tops. And then, yeah, each of these tops of these towers, the snow has made a cool pattern with the lighting on the outside, on the inside, which is kind of neat too. But you can see the whole town from up here. There's the dock and the market, the stable, the watchtower, the house, the cathedral, or monastery actually is what it's called in the game. Monastery, the barracks, the town center, the archery range, the mill, the blacksmith, the siege workshop. What else am I missing? The lumber mill. I think the mining camp is behind there. Yeah. Man, it's a lot of builds. And now the castle. So the only thing really left that I'm not going to be able to do, I think, is going to be the... that looks cool from up here, too. It does. The only thing I'm really not going to be able to do is the Wonder. The Wonder is probably the biggest build, and it's very much like a giant statue, if I remember correctly. And I don't have time to do that. One, to design it, and two, to plan it and to get the materials for it. Like, I don't have time. I just don't. So that's not going to be done. The Wonder's not necessary anyways, I don't think. Only if you're doing the Wonder Victory condition. But I should be able to do the what's it called? The University still, which is the only other one, which is kind of like a bookish one. You know, it's a university. I got to do that still. But, yeah. I think I'm pretty much done with the builds, at least. I got to do details here and there if I can, if I have time. But, like, I'm feeling pretty good about kind of completing this, even if it is not fully 100% complete the way I would want done. But at least it's, like, they're all built and kind of that way. It's taken me so long to kind of do all of this, too. It's kind of amazing that I've built these, like, four, and this one being the biggest build, these buildings within like the last month, which is more progress than I've made in like 6 months to a year out here, because I really didn't do very much for a long time. I was doing storyline stuff, I was doing other things with other people on the server. I can't remember what else I was distracted by. There's been so many things I've been distracted by that it's hard to keep track of them all. Let's try to add some vines up here too. Maybe a few. Maybe this will help. Maybe. I hope I don't have to strip all this out. We'll see. It should be okay, I think. Let's add a couple here. I tried to make it a little bit tiered so that it had a little bit more depth to it, but I'm not sure. It just kind of came out as one giant blob of a tree. I got to work on it still. I got to think about things, how I want to do this and that and the other thing. But anyways, I think this will be the end of the episode. I'm gonna do a screenshot of the outside of the building for the thumbnail, because it's so proud of this castle. I'm proud of the other buildings too, but I'm really proud of this castle. I've never done the big ones like this before. It's great. It's fantastic. I wish I'd done it sooner, but I wish I didn't have to do all the work to make it get there. You know, guys, you know what I mean? Anyways, let's see. Come on. Oh, I missed. I had to arch a little bit more. Let's try to go up here. Nope. Close. Try. Again. Try. Again. I did it. Third time's a charm. Yes. That's what it looks like. It looks... I love it. It looks great. I wish I could zoom to where it's like not so close, but at the same time, it's pretty cool. I like it. I like it, guys. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. Oh, I will see you all next time. Bye.